This is Aya, Lucas, Alex, and Sophia. Like all young people, they want to be healthy and happy, to understand their bodies, have good relationships, and avoid unintended pregnancy, violence, and sexually transmitted infections, including HIV. For this, they need good quality comprehensive sexuality education, CSE, at school. But what does it take to achieve this? It takes policies, curricula, well-trained teachers, and an enabling environment. Countries are at different stages on their journey towards providing age-appropriate and gender-sensitive CSE to all learners. Some countries are close to delivering it, others are lagging behind. Aya lives in a country where sexuality education is mandatory. Around 85% of countries have policies, laws, or legal frameworks that support the delivery of sexuality education. It is a great start, but doesn't always mean comprehensive sexuality education is good quality or even being delivered. Lucas lives in a country where there are dedicated teacher training programs and teachers feel confident in the classroom. But it is not like that for everyone. In many countries, teachers say they lack the knowledge, skills, and confidence to teach CSE. Young people often speak out about their need for CSE, but are disappointed with what they get. Only 1 in 3 say their school teaches sexuality education well. On the other side of the world, Alex is in a sexuality education lesson. 4 out of 5 countries report that they have sexuality education curricula, but it is often not comprehensive. Alex learns about reproductive health and puberty, but nobody mentions gender, relationships, or sex. Happily, in Alex's country, the government is reviewing the curricula, which will lead to the inclusion of a wider range of topics taught at the right age. Sophia lives in a country where there has been recent opposition to CSE. This is a worry, but a group of stakeholders were brought together to ensure the curricula was responsive to local context and help others understand the positive impacts of sexuality education. With parent and community support now in place, Sophia is on track to benefit. To make access to comprehensive sexuality education a reality for all young people, we need to invest in policy, curricula, teacher training, and developing supportive environments. This will allow countries to make strides on their journey towards CSE. Only then will Aya, Lucas, Alex, and Sophia have the skills and knowledge they need for a healthy and happy future.